Freeze, Ed! Whew. Tell her!
In a nation of laws, patriotism knows no greater champion than that which is found in a law enforcement officer. Boldly standing on the thin blue line separating peace from anarchy, the officer knows that the war will never end. The officer stands there anyway, a vigilant sentry, fighting the continual war one battle at a time. Lieutenant Aaron Allan courageously stood his post, representing what is best in society, going into places that an average person fears to tread, seeing things that no one wants to see. By simply going to work every day, Aaron made this country a better place to live. Therefore, we present Aaron a flag of the United States of America, a symbol of hope, with a prayer that will offer him the comfort of a grateful nation.
Mrs. Allan, members of the Allan family, members of the Southport Police Department. My name is Josh Minkler. I am the United States Attorney for the Southern District of Indiana. I'm here on behalf of federal law enforcement to offer our condolences. I have with me a letter from the Chief Federal Law Enforcement Officer for these United States of America, the Attorney General, which it would be my honor to read to you and to present to you today. Officer. Office of the Attorney General, Washington, D.C. Mrs. Stacy Allen. Mrs. Allen, on behalf of the entire United States Department of Justice, I write to extend to you our deepest condolences on the tragic loss of your husband, Lieutenant Aaron Allen. I was shocked and saddened to learn of the senseless act of violence that claimed his life. You and your sons, TJ and Aaron Jr., are in our thoughts and prayers during this difficult time. I have learned that Aaron was a remarkable man and an outstanding public servant during his 17 years in law enforcement, including the last 6 years with the Southport Police Department. Aaron willingly risked his life each day to protect his family, community, state, and country, and he handled every task with courage and composure. I understand that Aaron was honored as the inaugural Southport Officer of the Year in 2015. This is not a surprise, as all who knew Aaron would agree his actions showed that he served his community for the right reasons and in the right way. Aaron faithfully upheld the rule of law, but his fellow officers called him Teddy Bear because his love, his kindness, and his devotion to others was at the heart of all he did. In fact, I'm told that Aaron helped a member of my staff with a flat tire some years ago. Small acts of charity like this are a testament to his character and an example of God's love. I know Aaron's legacy of selflessness is something that TJ and Aaron Jr. will carry on with pride, knowing that their father was a true hero. I realize that no words of mine can ease your pain or relieve your sorrow, but I hope you can find some comfort in knowing that Aaron's life and extraordinary service will be revered and remembered by his extended law enforcement family, not only in Indiana, but throughout these United States of America. Sincerely, Jefferson B. Sessions, Attorney General, United States of America.
This is a day that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. We don't understand, and yet we rejoice. We are hurt, and yet we rejoice. We're grieving, and yet we rejoice. For the Lord of hosts is with us, the God of comfort is here. My name is Patricia Holman, and I am the staff chaplain for the Indianapolis Metropolitan Police Department. And we are here today to honor, to pay tribute to Lieutenant Aaron W. Allan from the Southport Police Department, taken from us July 27th, 2017. We don't pay tribute because of how he died. He is a hero because of how he lived. Our brother has fallen. The blue line. The blue line has been stained with blood. Today we will honor a great man. And we thank you for taking part on today. Coming to bring the invocation will be Dr. Chris Holland, pastor of the Father's House, after which there will be a musical tribute back to God.
Would you bow your heads, please, in an attitude of prayer? Father, we come together this day to celebrate the life of a man that gave his life for his city, for his fellow man, for his family, for his home, dedicated, sworn in duty and in honor. We stand before you today, Lord, in all of our dress, all of the things that we've prepared today to show this man the great honor he deserves in how he lived. But Lord, we are also behind these badges, underneath these clothes, and behind our eyes, humans with broken hearts, minds absolutely tormented with how can this happen, thoughts racing. And as we stand before you today, we stand very humble, seeking and desiring to know your wisdom, your plan, and your way for us from this day forward. We ask you, Lord, that you would comfort this precious family, his law enforcement family, and that you would comfort all of us that care, those that stand on the blue line, those that stand behind the blue line, that have dedicated and given our lives for righteousness and peace. We ask today for your deepest comfort in our spirit, where only you can touch, deep in our heart, where you know the very intimate part of man. We pray this now, we ask you now, we believe it by faith, and we receive it today by faith. In the name of Jesus the Christ, amen. Thank you.
I will have an Old Testament reading followed by a New Testament reading. The Old Testament will come from Psalm 46. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, even though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though its waters roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with its swelling. There is a river whose stream shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her just at the break of dawn. The nations rage, the kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice, the earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Come, behold the works of the Lord, who has made desolations in the earth. He makes wars cease to the end of the earth. He breaks the bow and cuts the spear in two. He burns the chariot in the fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Our New Testament reading will come from Matthew 5. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called children of God.
On behalf of the Allan family, Miss Stacy, and our awesome young men and little boy, TJ, and Allan Jr., Mr. Allan Jr., we want to say Honorable Governor and Senator Donnelly and Mayor McClure, Mayor Hogsett, Chief Vaughn, and Chief Roach, the command staff of Southport and all of its officers, along with the command staff of IMPD and all of its officers, and the community that's gathered here today. The love and the support that's been shown this week, just from Thursday, has been absolutely tremendous. The words that came from the family, even on television from the father and the family. It's been a tremendous outpouring of support, and we need to do more of that. Lieutenant Allan's tragic death has absolutely shocked and made all of us stop and realize where we are in our nation, in our state, in our city, in our communities, in our homes, and in our hearts. And so today I want to share a couple of things with you as the eulogist. And I brought with me a couple of tools, if you don't mind. If you're alive in 1501 in Florence, Italy, this is a sound that you would have heard on a day when an artist was asked to chisel out one of the greatest statues that the world has ever known, one of the greatest images that is sought by, viewed by, photographed for, and seen all over the world. People come from all over the world, have for years since then, finished in 1504, and that sound would have been the sound that you would have heard through those years. This piece of marble that was presented to this artist, nobody wanted to touch. No other artist, two others chosen, only one took the chance, because the other two artists were concerned about the fractures and the cracks that were in the marble. And they were concerned that at one point the marble would crumble and they would be left with embarrassment and with shame about what they had come to do for this great town. Not under the hand of a master, and not under the hand of the master that took it upon himself at 26 years old to say, "I'll be the one and I'll do it for you." He knows that deep inside There's something special, but on the outside, there's only jagged edges and sharpness, and there's rough parts, and there's, it just looks like just a chunk of marble, but on the inside, there's something that's very valuable and very precious to all of humanity, and he alone is the only one that can see it. When asked how he sees the carved image, he's carving in the marble slab, he replies, "The image is already in the marble. All I have to do is remove the excess that surrounds it so that you then can see what I see on the inside." I brought these little tools with me today as a reminder to you and to me that just like that slab of marble, so are you and so am I as we start out our lives. 1983, Lieutenant Aaron W. Allen, at the age of 5, decided to be a police officer. Kind of a rough slab of marble. There's another little young man in here today that's about 5 years old, and in his heart, he's decided to be a police officer, and everybody's encouraging him. But he's not a police officer yet. He has a little plastic badge, can't carry a real one, and he has a little plastic gun, he can't carry a real one. He's got a little plastic police car. He's gonna drive around, but on the inside, he is a police officer, as big and as strong and as powerful as any officer that stands, sits, or walks in this room today. And in his eyes, he wants to fulfill the calling in the shoes of our fallen comrade that lays before us today. He answers the call in his heart at the age of 5 and begins his destiny and his purpose. For his life, he's just a boy, a piece of marble hiding something on the inside. And then in 1999, a drill instructor for the United States Air Force took a chisel in hand and moved towards his life and began to carve out the image of Aaron Allen as a military man. Oh, but when he got down to part, it didn't work. Why? Because it wasn't what was on the inside. And due to an illness, a struggle in his body, a severe illness, he was granted a medical discharge, and he moved on to another sculptor. Aaron began the shaping process through his parents, who are here with us today. He began with teachers, many teachers. He began with many people in his life and mentors, and yes, drill instructors from Indiana Academy for Law Enforcement. The image of a fine man and a fine police officer begins to take shape, and everybody can see it that knows him and that's around him. 2001, he served as the civilian police volunteer for IPD. 2004, Marion County Sheriff's Department. 2009, resource officer for Indiana School for the Deaf. 2011, a resource officer for Franklin Township Schools. In 2011, he begins as a reserve officer for Southport Police Department. 2017, he is now the first full-time officer of Southport Police Department. And I wish I could have been there on that day, because I've learned loving about this man, and I've enjoyed actually getting, and I guarantee, I'll bet you he was an absolute blast. 10 years, he worked as an officer at the fairgrounds, where we see him, as it appears, a fine police officer in the making. Many people may see a tough exterior, just like you may look around today and look at guys and ladies who have a very somber face. We see a tough exterior, tickets written. Oh, you know, the more anger and cursing you spew, the more tickets there are for you. The handcuffs, always ready. The chase, you're gonna get ran down, I guarantee. The drugs or alcohol sniffed out like a crime dog, a canine. However, if you need help with something, he's the man you call. If you need help with something common, that's the guy you want on the phone. Because his answer is, "Hey, bud, what's up?" Not ever sounding like he's tired of sleep or that he hadn't had any rest that night and had just gotten home. The image begins to show little by little in his life. As he stands before the public's eyes, some people call him a mean, Officer Cody, did you get into my message? Oh, okay. So it looks like some of the things you wrote in my notes. Somebody throw some candy at him, please. If you notice that only Southport officers are laughing, it's because these are things that they shared and things that they get. The problem is that these people that say these things are shallow. They don't see past the outside surface area of an officer's life. Those who know this work of art the best see simply the teddy bear. The teddy bear is a story where, as tough as Lieutenant Aaron is, and as strong and powerful as he is, and as strict as he is about the law, he had such a caring side that even if your car needed a battery, you'd take money out of his own pocket and go buy one and put it in your car. By the way, the battery is still in the car, still running today. I found out. So when he got back, someone said, "Oh man, Aaron, you're not a tough backside. You're just a teddy bear." And it stuck with him forever. They hear the peals of laughter as he keys your mic and gets you to call dispatch when it's really him talking to you. They see the man who's filled with compassion so deep that he will also throw up, even if he's on a call, if he sees that you're throwing up, out of compassion, of course, so you're not alone. He bought things and he raised money to help people complete tasks in their lives, such as the little boy who wants to be a police officer. And he got together to buy him a little electric car. These people that know him the best, they see the man and they know that he'll always have your back. And they also know that he never seems to be afraid. Even on the day that his life was tragically taken, he wasn't running away. He wasn't hiding. He wasn't sitting in his car hoping somebody else would do it. No, sir, no, ma'am. He was in the car and he was taking care of business when his life was taken. That's the kind of men and women I love to be around. That's the kind of image that I love to see in the life of a man. Often seeming tireless, but always on the job. On Thursday, July the 27th, 2017, this wonderful masterpiece was attacked, killed in the line of duty, doing what he loved and what had shaped and carved out his life, his destiny, and his purpose. And may he today remind you and me and all of us and all those who are listening by way of television or internet that every day of our lives we're presented before the master carver. And if we'll allow him, he'll place us in the right place at the right time, doing the right thing. If you ask about the statue that I spoke about at the beginning of my story and my eulogy, that man was none other than Mr. Michelangelo, and that statue was none other than King David, that he carved out to provide men who were in warfare, a surge of courage and a surge of hope in their darkest and most difficult hour in Florence. I say today that we stand to honor the life of this wonderful man who gave his life for his community. Thank you. Thank you.
cup of coffee and one more kiss before I walk out the door. You said I love you 1,000 times. I still say love you more. You pull me close and you hold me tight, hoping it won't be the last time. Then you tell
At this time, we'll have remarks by the Honorable Eric Holcomb, Governor of the State of Indiana, followed by the Honorable Joseph Donnelly, Senator, State of Indiana, followed by the Honorable Russell McClure, Mayor from the City of Southport, followed by the Honorable Joseph Hogsett, Mayor of the City of Indianapolis, followed by Chief Tom Vaughn, Southport Police Department.
Our hearts are heavy today and will be for many days to come. A wife has lost a husband, parents lost a son, children lost their dad. In Indiana, Indiana has lost a hero, Lieutenant Aaron Allan, the Southport Police Department. On behalf of an eternally grateful state, we offer our deepest condolences. And looking out to those who have assembled here today, I see a sea of shared sorrow and grief. But I also see and I feel love. Lieutenant Allan was clearly loved a lot. And we know God loves him as well, and he has called him home. St. Augustine said, "What does love look like? It has hands to help others. It has the feet to hasten to the poor and the needy. It has eyes to see misery and want. It has ears to hear the sighs and the sorrows of men." That is what love looks like. I read that quote the other night and immediately thought of Lieutenant Allan. Aaron Allan is what love looks like. Certainly his hands helped countless others. His feet, took him into harm's way numerous times to protect his friends and his neighbors, to protect your family and mine. His eyes saw want and suffering, and he tried to better it. His ears heard sorrows, and he tried to right them. We will never be able to repay all the debts that we owe Lieutenant Allan. But we can and we must honor him. We can honor him by doing exactly what he dedicated his life to doing, answering the call, serving those in need, giving back to our communities, leaving our little corner of the world a little better than we found it, just exactly like he did every day. To Stacy and the whole family, I just want to say that, and you know this, you do not grieve alone. Just look around you. Your family just got a whole heck of a lot bigger. I'd say to the tune of about 6.6 plus million Hoosiers strong and a lot of other folks from around the nation. To his brothers and his sisters in blue and in brown and in green, you too aren't alone. We support you. We're grateful for you. And when I go to the Lord later tonight and for many nights to come, I'll pray for healing for Aaron's family, his fellow officers, and healing for this community. And at the very same time, I will give thanks. I'll give thanks to God that although he welcomed Aaron back home too soon, he graced Indiana with Aaron in the first place, and he touched us all beyond description. And in the midst of this senseless tragedy, I will find some comfort and derive daily strength from that. For I know that for those who live in the Lord, never say goodbye for the last time. And I know that with every step on earth that Aaron took, he threw off light and love. And that love and that light will shine down every day until we all meet again. Rest in peace, Aaron Allan.
It breaks all of our hearts to be here today. But to be here for such an extraordinary person. Governor, Congressman Rakita, to our mayors, our chiefs, all our city council, to all our men and women in blue, in brown, in green, to the people of Southport. Such an amazing place. Most of all, to Stacy and Jim and Sherry and Lori and TJ and Aaron Jr., to his brother and sister, to grandma, to the whole family, on behalf of the people of the United States, and as the governor said, on behalf of the people of the state of Indiana, there's no way we can ever repay you or thank you for such an extraordinary person. Jim, what an amazing guy. What an incredible person, an Air Force veteran, IMPD volunteer, Marion County Sheriff volunteer, constant devotion to everybody, School for the Deaf, to the State Fair. At the State Fair, It's incredible what he accomplished there. In 2015, Southport Department Policeman of the Year for saving lives there. At the State Fair, he gave CPR and saved another life there. He was a devout volunteer, leader, an incredible role model in Southport, who believed in community policing and stopped to get to know everybody. And you just looked at him and you could see the smile on his face. As the Reverend was saying, can you imagine meeting someone and the next thing you know, you're in an auto parts store buying a battery for them with your own money? Because he knew that that family was in a tough spot and he could help them out. It's character. It's devotion. Stacy, he was an amazing man, as you well know. You look at that and you see a hero of Indiana, but not just of Indiana, to the country. This is what America is made of. This is when we think of our police, when we think of our fire, who go into the buildings when others are coming out, who rush to help when everyone's in danger. And to all these families here, when your spouse or loved one heads out on patrol, you never know. But you go there anyhow. You go there because you love your community, you love your job, and you have a vocation, a calling, a dedication. And it is breathtaking what kind of man he was. You made him, Stacy, an even better person. To TJ and Aaron Jr., all he had to do was look at the picture. You were the lights of his lives. To Jim and Sherry and Lori, you gave us a staggering, amazing person who saved lives, who touched lives, and who made people's lives better. And so from all of us, thank you. Thanks for his spirit, his smile, his heart, and his kindness, and for everything he's done for all of us. And we believe this, we believe that he is with God. And Stacy, we believe we'll see him again, and that the kids will be with him again, and that all of us will get a chance to say thank you to him again. But until that time, rest in peace. We can't wait to see you. And God bless you, and thank you.
these past few days, this past week, has been an ordeal no family, no police department, and no city should ever have to endure. Lieutenant Aaron Allan gave his life in the service of others. He was more than just an outstanding officer. He was a dedicated husband to Stacy, a father to TJ and Aaron Jr., son to his father James and Sherry, and his mother Laurie, brother to Ryan and Corey, grandson to Shirley. He was also a true friend. John 15:13 says, "Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends." And that is just what Lieutenant Allan has done. And that's what every police officer is willing to do every day. Lieutenant Allan is a true hero, a man who was dedicated to his family and dedicated to his work as a police officer. Aaron was an excellent example of what a law enforcement officer should be. He was competent, dedicated, tenacious, and tough. In speaking to many former and current colleagues, the overriding theme is the same. Aaron was a competent, dedicated professional. But he also could be compassionate, caring, earning him the nickname Teddy Bear. We are fortunate to witness Lieutenant Allan's dedication by his saving lives and his compassion through providing for other people he did not know. Aaron and I share a common interest in hunting and fishing. There were times in the office where we would trade stories. You know how those go. Fish gets bigger. Each exaggerating our exploits to the point where you'd think that both of us had dispatched a charging grizzly bear with a piece of duct tape and a paper clip. That's just kind of how we went back at each other. There were other times where we would throw candy at each other for no reason. Just walk in and you get hit in the chest with a piece of chocolate. Lieutenant Allan also had a serious side. He would want us to focus on the goals of our departments. He would want us to stay focused on our commitment to the safety and the well-being of those around us. He would want us to serve others. Aaron was committed to making a difference, and he did. Police departments are not buildings or vehicles or equipment. Police departments are people. Police departments are the men and women who selflessly serve their communities with integrity, who work tirelessly so our citizens can live in safety and security. Police departments are people like Lieutenant Allan. We're all hurting. The loss of Aaron has cut us to the core, but it has also strengthened our resolve. It has strengthened our communities. I am confident that God will use this tragedy for good. My prayer is that we will always remember and never forget. My prayer is that God will lift up the family of Lieutenant Allan and heal their wounds. My prayer is that God will keep and protect all of our police officers, first responders, and their families. To borrow Isaiah chapter 6, verse 8, "Then I heard the Lord voice of the Lord saying, 'Whom shall I send? And who will go for us?' And Aaron said, 'Here am I, send me.'" Godspeed, Lieutenant Allan. You are irreplaceable and you will be missed.
We the living, we the grateful, we their legacy. Twice this week, Indianapolis has paid witness to the perils attached to protecting the public's safety. Tragedies like this one often hinder police departments from adding officers, and understandably so. How can we ask someone to walk into that valley? But we do. And they do. To the family of Lieutenant Allan, thank you for allowing us to be with you today. Just as we were together earlier this week in Southport, it was National Night Out. And in the years before, Aaron Allan always volunteered for the dunk tank. This year, his father filled that role. And this coming Monday, someone will fill Lieutenant Allan's role on duty. That's what we do in the wake of such a tragedy. Fill the roles left by the loved ones we've lost. But we will never, ever be able to replace the one who first filled them. Our community's true heroes take up the cause despite the shadows in the valley and carry on with courage. Lieutenant Aaron Allan took up that cause. May we all live with increasing devotion to the memory of Lieutenant Allan. May we all be a little more like this good man. Amen.
Please bear with me. I didn't lose an officer. I lost a friend. Aaron loved his wife and his children, hunting and fishing and police work. And I think it was pretty much in that order. Stacy and Ellen were made for each other. You could see it when they looked. Every time they looked in each other's eyes, you just saw that bond. Stacy, Aaron loved you and the boys with all his heart. Stacy, TJ, Aaron Jr., I want you to know that we support you guys from here and now. You're part of the family, whether you really want to be or not now, you're not going to be able to get away from us. I cannot be more proud of the Southport police officers who do this job every day without any pay. It takes a strong commitment for a community to want to protect them. You and all the other officers across this nation get dressed every day with eyes wide open to the risk of not coming home. I want you all to know that the community is overwhelmingly grateful for you, and as we can see in the past week, support us. This past week, I've met countless officers who have come from near and far to show their support. Men and women of law enforcement, I want you to know justice will be served. Righteousness will always prevail. The job we do every day is very important. 7 square miles of our community has undergone 3 national events: Richmond Hills, the pastor tragically killed, and now Aaron Allan killed in the line of duty. Our community has displayed resolve and resilience over and over. Our community continues to wrap their arms around us, and we are very grateful. On Monday night, I had the honor of some of the officers were able to go to Kokomo, Indiana to meet an impressive child named Malachi. Malachi heard the news about Aaron and just wanted to show his support. He set up a lemonade stand to raise money for Aaron's family. He also trained me how to make lemonade. I wasn't doing it right. This is just one of the many acts of kindness that has been shown to us in this past week. I want the community to know that our officers will continue to relentlessly run towards accidents to preserve life. We are here and will continue to be here, and we truly appreciate everyone's support. Thank you.
At this time, we'll have a musical tribute sung by Lieutenant Brian Wolf of the Marion County Sheriff's Department, Amazing Grace, the Policeman's Tribute.
Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found. Was blind, but now I see. Love that made
We'll now have remembrances. Sergeant Christopher Berry, Deputy Lonnie Helton, Deputy Robert Lane, and Lieutenant John Livingston from the Marion County Sheriff's Department, followed by the music of Lee Bryce, Boy, followed by the message coming from Dr. Chris Holland.
Aaron, or Allan as we like to call him, was not just our best friend. We were all close as brothers. Allan and I met at the Sheriff's Department 13 years ago. I remember our first conversation. I asked him who his favorite football team was. He told me Tampa Bay. I was so excited since I've always been a Buccaneer fan myself. I couldn't believe I found another Buccaneer fan in Colts country. I think we're two of about five. Our bond over football was immediate. Now, we didn't see the same on baseball. He loved the St. Louis Cardinals. I loved the Cubs. So you can imagine there was a little tension there. Sports bonded us, but it was so much more that brought us together. We never argued over sports or anything. Being friends with Allan was easy. I was the best man in his wedding. I was there moments after his son was born. The four of us all camped together. We fished together. We did everything together. We worked a lot of part-time security jobs together. So much that we saw each other more than we saw our own families. We've been involved in our share of issues, like the state fair stage collapse. It was strange. We never trained together, but we had a connection and unspoken ability to understand what the other was thinking and support each other on various scenes and situations. He always had our six. Because of who he was to the four of us, it's important that I stand here today with the strength of Allan to tell you about our friend. Allan gave everyone a chance. His life was about helping and loving others. He had a way of bringing different people from different backgrounds together. He accepted people for who they were. He judged no one. He was a cop's cop. He respected the law and lived his life by the code of the law. He was a true community officer. He loved and supported his community. It was his honor to serve with everyone. He was a man of his word. He helped people, like the time he bought a car battery for a lady who needed one, or waited 2 hours for another lady to get out of traffic court to give her car keys back, which she had lost. He would check up on people if they were down on their luck. Allan was there to help them or to cheer them up. When I was going through a very difficult time in my life, Allan was my rock. He stuck with me. He stuck with everyone. Allan only loved one more thing than law enforcement, besides maybe hunting: his family. He had Stacy, the woman of his dreams, TJ and little Aaron, his pride and joys. He had the career he always wanted, a police officer, and he was the best friend anyone could ever want.
Allan gave us many gifts, not the monetary kind, but the kind that come from the heart. The last gift he gave me was his time. Brother. You see, I just had lunch with Allan about an hour before he was called to the scene of a car being flipped. I didn't know at the time, but it was our last meal. Our last time to talk, our last time together. But I think back to that lunch and I see it as a gift from God and from Allan, that I was one of the last people he spent time with. Right before he took off, I said, "Love you, brother. Be safe." Had I known he was leaving, never to return, I would have tried my best to stop him, but he would have gone anyway. That's what he did. He went to help someone. He lived his life to help and serve. So I think about the last time, those last moments. And God knew what he was doing. He wanted us to have one last conversation, one more chance to say, "Love you, brother. Be safe."
Tall, run like you're bulletproof and total a car too. Boy, you're gonna hate this town. Wish you could burn it down. That fire in your eyes is 20 counties wide. But boy, you're gonna love 17. And boy, you'll do some stupid things. You're gonna drive and kiss and throw a punch and grow up way too fast. You're gonna drop the ball, hit the wall, and break some hearts like glass. I know you will, 'cause you're a part of me and a part of you, and will always be a boy. Gonna be so stubborn. You get that from your mother. I already see it now. You weren't built for backing down. Boy, there'll be a small town night. You'll fall for her sky blue eyes. When she's in your hands, you'll think you're a man and not a boy. She'll make you lose your mind. Boy, you'll be every reason why. You're gonna drive and kiss and throw a punch and grow up way too fast. You're gonna drop the ball, hit the wall, and break some hearts like glass. I know you will, 'cause you're a part of me and a part of you will always be. You're gonna come back home. You're gonna settle down. But you won't feel the way I'm feeling now. Until you have a boy, he's gonna know it all.
He'll think he's 10 feet tall. Run like he's bulletproof and total a car too.
Stacy, thank you for loving him. If he were able to talk to you right now at this moment, I think he would say, babe, this is why I was teaching you to slow down. Because the moments of life, according to the Word of God, are as a vapor. And they seem like they're going to last forever, but then they're gone. And sometimes in our life, we get so busy being busy that we don't stop and take the time and slow down and see everything there really is to be seen and enjoy everything there really is to be enjoyed about one another and about our lives together on this planet. I don't know if he would say thank you for teaching me how to wear shorts and sandals instead of blue jeans and cowboy boots and show my white legs to everybody in Antigua. He may, I don't know. He seemed to, he wore them after that, right? And thanks for talking me into eating the hottest ice cream I've ever had in my whole life with indigestion. The story goes that he would just about do anything. I like this guy because growing up in the mountains of North Carolina as old country boy myself, I was a double dog dare you guy. Anybody in here ever been a double dog dare you guy? So he was a double dog dare you guy, and he liked doing anything on a dare. So he would just do whatever there was to get a good rush. And so he got talked into eating some ice cream that had like ghost pepper sauce on it or something. And he eats it, gets a mouthful, and eats it, and he's doing good. And all of a sudden, sweat starts breaking out on his head. And when you have no hair, you can't hide it. And it's dripping everywhere. And you know our favorite thing to say even today, and it's probably been said several thousand times this week. You good? I'm good. You good? You all right? I'm all right. It's the favorite cover-up phrase for law enforcement, which says, I'm really not good and I'm really hurting on the inside, but I got to cover that up because I don't want anybody else to think I'm hurting, because if they do, then I appear weak. The Bible says when you and I are weak, in our weakness, that God is made strong in us. And there are things in life that are bigger than you and bigger than me that we really can't handle. Two funerals in 1 week of law enforcement officers. Today, we're saying goodbye to a fallen hero. It's a lot, and it's over the top for a law enforcement family to have to deal with in our communities. I was absolutely excited to learn about his love for his wife. I always look at that. You can, as a pastor, you can always tell the kind of caliber a man is and was by talking to his wife, whom he is in covenant with. He didn't make an agreement with and sign a contract. He was in covenant with her. And so when you sit and talk with the wife, you can tell what kind of man he is, because she will reveal it from her heart. Out of the abundance of her heart, her mouth will speak. And so to take a guy that loves camouflage, ooh-rah, hunting, ooh-rah, bass fishing, which is one of my favorites. I'm a bass fisherman. 8 pounds, 6 5-ounces is my biggest so far. I'm gonna get 10 pounds one day. But to talk to a guy, to be around a guy, that's what he does. He loves spraying animal urine on himself. Sorry, it's just what we do. But that's also a guy that will walk into Tiffany's because he loves his girl. and will buy her something special from a very fancy woman store. That's my kind of guy. He knows how to be tough, hard, deal with life issues, have a strong jaw, but he also knows how to watch his woman, see what she likes, and go get it for her. Even if it means to paint a gun pink or Tiffany color, so she'll have what she wants from her heart. That's my kind of guy. That's the kind of guy I like. I used to watch my wife when we would go to the mall, and she would buy everything for everybody else, me, the boys, and always hang her stuff back and hang it back up and say, "Huh, honey, it's okay. I'll get something later if I really want it." But that's the very thing I would go back, and it's amazing how ladies in those stores will help a guy if he really wants to be a blessing to his wife. And they'll get you shoes, they'll get you earrings, man, they'll by the time you get done, hey, it's a kissing party when you get home, let me tell you. Because you're being a blessing. And it's okay. I know why his name is really the teddy bear, because it's okay to be tough, isn't it, Dad? But also to be tender. And to lead your men in a tough way, but when you get home, lead your wife in a tender way. To take your child by the hand and to walk him to school on his first day when he's unsure, not sure what he's gonna expect. But Dad's got his hand, and his hand is in Dad's hand. It's the same way for you and me. We're formed out of the dust of the earth, just like Michelangelo made the statue. You and I are formed by God from the dust of the earth and put on the inside of us. Unlike what great sculptors can do, God was able to breathe and blow into us and put into us a living soul and a living heart. And that heart is what drives us, takes us forward. That DNA that's on the inside of you made you what you are today, a desire to become one of the best on the planet, and that's a law enforcement officer. You're not weird. Don't ever let anybody tell you you're weird. All the cadets in here, let me tell you, you're not weird. On the inside of you is destiny and purpose. On the inside of this man was destiny and purpose and a desire to rise up and protect. For some reason, you're driven to do what's right. For some reason, you're driven to the truth instead of a lie. For some reason, you're driven to hold people accountable that want to hurt other people, destroy life, take, harm, or steal. For some reason, it's not some weird reason. It's the very thing that God birthed you into this earth for and put his very heart on the inside of you to say, rise up, stand up today, and be my ambassador in the earth for righteousness and truth. We forget that because sometimes everything doesn't go our way. We forget that because sometimes things go differently than what we expected or what we thought was gonna happen. But in Genesis chapter 2 and verse 7, the Bible says that God breathed the breath of, he saw what he had molded and made and that it had no life in it, and so he breathed his very breath into the very first man, Adam. And from him, ladies and gentlemen, all of us came. That DNA is on the inside of you. That purpose is on the inside of you. It's what drives you to be the best you can be. And somewhere along the way, sometimes we forget that it is because of God you're able to do what you do. That it's because of the heart of God that you stand for what you stand for. For he is all righteous, and he is all holy, and he is all truth, and he is all integrity. It is not what he tries to be, it is what he is. And I want to tell you, as a community, as a city, as a state, and as a nation, thank you. Thank you to Aaron, and thank you to all of you that fill this room today, that stand up to do what you do. Some people may say in the public square, we don't want you, that's a lie. We need you on that blue line. We want you on that blue line. And yes, we can handle the truth. Some people may say, they don't take care of us. And I'm telling you, that's a lie. And I came today to honor this man, but I also came today to honor you and tell you, without men and women like this precious man, Lieutenant Aaron Allan, that lies before us, no one wants to live in this society. This husband, this father, but also this great man that stands for truth and righteousness. We need you to be those people. We want you to be those people. And we are honored that you stand as those who honor truth and justice and right. Justice stands on your shoulders every day and every night. And on top of your red and blue lights, and it stands beside of you, and we stand with you. There are four calls in every person's life. Three of them you have no choice about. One of them you do, but you shouldn't ignore it. One of those calls is you're called to be born. You don't get to choose your parents. You don't get to choose how you came into this world. You're born. Aaron didn't get to choose his mom and dad. They chose him. And we're brought into this earth. Every person in this room had to answer that call. No one is separated from this call. You were born, and you were called to be born, Ecclesiastes chapter 3. The second call that comes into a person's life is they're called to die. There is a call. Every one of us in this room, we're going to pass this way. Every one of us in this room, you may not have honors, you may not have police honors, you may not have a procession, but every person in this room will walk this way, take their last breath, and they will enter into eternity. No one is exempt from that. No one. There's not an amount of money that you can pay to refute the fact that you and I, we're not immortal, we're mortal. And at moments like this, we face our mortality. At moments like this, we face the fact that life can be bigger than us and death can be bigger than us. You're called. There is an appointment, the Bible says, unto man. There's an appointed time. The third call is you're appointed or called to be who you are. Two greatest moments in any person's life is when they're born, and the second is when they understand their purpose and their destiny in life. It's so easy sometimes for people who have locked in on what they were called to do deep in their heart, as a five-year-old would be, to say, I want to be a police officer, and that's exactly what you become. The road to get there may not be easy, but the peace and joy of knowing you know who you are is a strength in every life. And that call calls out to you. It calls out to you to stand up against the bullies of life. It calls out to you to stand up against the evils that lurk in darkness to harm and hurt those who are unexpectedly passing by. The fourth call that you and I receive in our lives and that we can ignore, but my friends, you and I should not ignore, is the call of God for his honor and for your heart. To not understand that God is why you and I are here and what you uphold in his righteous truth every day is like putting someone else's name on the great statue, the King David, knowing that Michelangelo is the one that carved it. I believe that in our hearts, especially in the law enforcement community, we have a deep reality and understanding, as Allan had, of what righteousness is, because you stand for it. You stand for right. You stand for truth. You stand and you raise your hand, and on your word, lives are changed or moved in courts of law.
because your word has been proven to be truth. You and I, above all, should understand the God of all creation that created you and me, and honor him with our lives, with our hearts, and with our loves, because today in our society, we need the reverence of God. Our streets need to understand the reverence of God again. And I'm gonna tell you, ladies and gentlemen, I'm praying for a revival. I'm praying that things that we're dealing with today and we have this week stir in all of our heart a deep revival for what is right. And I want to tell you, the masses are those that love you, not the small voices, not the small crowds you see, not the ones that sometimes get all of the TV time. I'm talking about those who really know the truth, love the truth, pray the truth, and live the truth. And there are masses in our nation that stand for righteousness, that stand for what this man died for, and love the right things of God. And we're praying. We're praying that it shakes our heart and it shakes our lives and it shakes our communities to where when people walk down the street, the moral fabric of a man's heart leads him to do what's right, not do what's wrong. And that we care more for one another than we care for ourselves, as our lieutenant so proudly and so desperately showed us to do. I want to say thank you to all of you for sharing his life with us and sharing his stories with us. And Stacy, this is a huge family. They don't go away tomorrow. They don't go away next week. We don't go away ever. And there's love in this room for you, your family, your children. Sir, for you, your wife, for all of those that are family and friends and comrades. We love you. We appreciate you. And as a community, I want to say we stand for you and we pray for you daily. And we give great honor and great joy in our hearts for the life of this man. May you and I rise up, stand strong. And every day that you go out and make that choice and face what you face, may you face it knowing today that there is a comfort that is greater than just a physical touch, because it won't be enough. There's a comfort greater than just a spoken word, because it will never be enough. There's a comfort that goes to the piercing of the spirit of man. And that's the comfort that only the Holy Spirit can provide. And if you'll put your faith and your trust in God, he will absolutely bring that comfort into your heart in these days. God bless you. God bless your family. And God bless those who stand on the blue line.
Then I am still and wait here.
Father, we put our lives and our hope in you. And we trust you. We stand today filled with hope for tomorrow because of your grace and your precious gift that you gave. As we leave this place today with all of the thoughts and the memories and the joys of Lieutenant Aaron W. Allen's life, we ask you, Lord, that you go with us and that you keep ministering to us. We thank you, Lord, for the family and for the friends and for his law enforcement family and all the extended members of the community. We all need a touch from heaven today. We thank you, Lord God, that you receive it. And we thank you, Lord, that your hand of mercy is upon us now. We give you praise and glory and honor for all things. In Jesus the Christ's name we pray. Amen. Thank you.
On July 27, 2017, Southport Police Department, Lieutenant Aaron W. Allan answered his phone call. While rendering aid to an accident victim, Lieutenant Allan was shot multiple times and killed. There is no greater love than a man that would lay down his life for another. Southport Police Department, Lieutenant Aaron W. Allan, Southport 10, is 1042. He has gone home for the final time.
Officer, please stand. In prayer, please. Our Father God, here in the presence of death, we know that you are the source of life, that our very breath is a gift from your hands. We thank you for the comfort we receive from your presence and ask that you hear us now as we call upon you for consolation and strength. As we try to mend the broken threads of our lives, we turn to you. May we live each day in the awareness that we too shall walk through the valley of the shadow. May our hearts be open to you, to your word, and our lives be lived in your service until that day when we step from this life into the life to come. We thank you for your grace and your mercy, for Stacy and for the family, for all of us that say goodbye to our comrade, our friend, and to the man that gave his life for his community and for what he believed. We thank you now. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.
For as much as it has pleased Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of this world the soul of our brother, Aaron Allan, we therefore commit his body to the ground. earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the resurrection at the last day and the life of the world to come through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose coming to judge the world, the earth and the sea shall give up their dead. The bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and be made like his glorious body, according to that power by which he is able to subdue all things unto himself.